changing minds, changing attitudes, bring ourselves to live a busy one, show some love, hold each other.
Welcome to the Princess Pat Akpabio Show. On this show, we change minds and change attitudes on how you perceive things in life generally. In life, we have so many questions but fewer answers concerning certain issues that we are facing. And that's why I'm here, to give you the kind of answers that you may be looking for the questions that you have. I am your friend, I am your sister, I am your coach. I'm here to make your day a blissful one. Welcome.
We are changing minds and changing attitudes.
You are watching the Princess Pat Akpabio Show.
On this particular episode today, I will be discussing with you ways to survive. Ways to survive as we continue to deal with the pandemic, the COVID-19 pandemic, and how to deal with the pandemic, that's post-pandemic era.
Change your minds and change your attitudes.
Now, I know a lot of people are going through a lot of things right now. Some people are going through depression. A lot of people are suffering from indecision. Some people are confused, don't know what to do with themselves at this particular point in time. Some people have probably lost their jobs, especially entrepreneurs. You know, with a lot of the news that we are hearing right now about the economic depression in the world today. And so I just want to take our time today to have a little chit chat with you and just discuss with you what I have come to discover about how to survive the post-pandemic era. Now, I know that we've lost loved ones. A lot of us have lost loved ones. We've been affected, either friends, family members, to this COVID-19 era. And a lot of people don't even know what to do with themselves as it is right now. Now, some people are going through hopelessness. Some people are so disheartened. A lot of people are in tears right now. They're looking for jobs. The rise of unemployment is everywhere right now in the world. And don't let anybody fool you or lie to you that they are okay. Trust me, everybody is feeling the pinch. Everybody's feeling the bite. Everybody is just uncomfortable somewhere, somehow. People have been disconnected from their loved ones. I have been disconnected from my loved ones right now because we are living in two different continents of the world. But that doesn't mean that we should give up hope at any point in time. I want to assure you that there is good news for you, that you can make it, that you're going to come out strong even after the COVID-19 pandemic is over with. But I want to assure you that it will be over soon. But while we are waiting for it to be over soon, how do we survive? How do we deal with the post-pandemic era? So now, how are you going to survive? How am I going to survive? How do we cope with having enough for ourselves and our household? And so before I start giving you ways to survive during this pandemic and post-pandemic, click on that subscribe button on this YouTube channel to subscribe to my channel, and also click on that bell so that you'll be notified each time I have content for you. Now let's get started. Number one, to survive. Number one, to survive. During the pandemic and post-pandemic era, number one is survival. What do I mean by survival? You have to stay afloat. You have to leave. Now, I understand, yes, that your businesses have suffered. You don't know where the next meal is going to come from. You don't know how you're going to pay your rent. You don't know how you're going to pay car notes. You don't know how you're going to pay for a lot of things. You cannot allow this COVID-19 pandemic depress you to a point where it buries you. You have to stay alive. You have to stay afloat. You must be determined to live through this era. You must be determined to live through this era because this era would pass away. You have to look out for yourself. You have to look out for yourself by following the guidelines that government has given and health professionals on how to survive, on how to stay safe, on how to protect yourself and your family. Survival is number one. Because what kills hope is death. If you are not alive, all your dreams will go away. The day you die, that's it. It's over. So instead of you getting so depressed to a point that you forget that there is hope at the end of the tunnel, there's light at the end of the tunnel, you have to stay alive. You have to live. I mean, I cannot overemphasize the fact that the number one way to deal with this pandemic is to stay alive. Survival. You must first of all tell yourself, I am going to make it. I'm going to live through this pandemic. It is not going to destroy me. It is not going to kill me. I and my family, we are going to make it through. Number two, you have to re-strategize your business to stay afloat. You have to re-strategize your business to stay afloat. What do I mean by that? Now, it's okay to follow your dreams. Don't get me wrong. Now, what possibly could be your dream? Your dream possibly could be that you want to own a car lot or you want to go into a car lot business. That's fine and that's okay. But in this pandemic era and post-pandemic era, with the war saying there is depression in the economy, well, how are you going to do that? All right, let's say this. Let's put it this way. You're a mechanic. You fix people's cars. How can you fix cars, old cars, rebrand it and make it new, especially for those people that don't want to buy new cars? I'm sure there is a way as a mechanic you can think about how you can fix a new car and rebrand it and make it become a new car. Are you a car dealer? Are you a dealership? I'm sure you know that there are so many incentives that you can give to buyers that will make them decide to buy. It's a kind of incentive that you give to people during this pandemic and after the pandemic era that will keep you in business. Now, listen, this is not the time to dabble into a new kind of investment, a new kind of business. Why? Because again, people are really looking at making do with what they have right now. So in order to help them make do with what they have now, how do you make it efficient for them? As a service provider, as a dealership, as a food, a restaurant, how can you help people to survive even as a business owner by the services that you provide for people? Look, you can do it. I know that there is something that you can do in your business that can help people to be interested in making sure that they come to you to get what they want. Whatever you do as a business owner in this time, this is not the time to get yourself involved in new business ventures, but this is the time making sure that the money that you have is going to be enough for you and your family, is enough to last you until when the economy bounces back. Now, remember, we are in a new normal, all right? Things are not what they used to be before. So now we have to make sure that we are self-sufficient. So many people are depressed. If they're not depressed, they're going into depression because of what things are. A lot of people's expectation in terms of their businesses, expectations of their finances has been cut short. I'm sure somebody was expecting 1 million naira, it never came. Somebody was expecting $20,000 profit, it never came. That does not mean that all hope is lost. That doesn't mean that it is finished with your business. I strongly believe that if you can re-strategize your business and check out the services that you offer and how you can even make it better by giving incentive to your customers and even potential customers, you will stay afloat. Whatever you do, make sure that you don't get buried during this COVID-19 and the post-pandemic era. Stay afloat. You don't have to be depressed. It is not over until you win. Number three, financial survival. How do you survive it? How do you make it during this pandemic and post-pandemic era? Number three, financial survival. Now, shares are falling. Economic downturns. We have so many fold up in the world today, in businesses, unemployment. So what do you do to make money? You can still follow your dreams. Remember I said that? You can still follow your dreams. You can still make it happen. But the reality of the moment is staying afloat. The reality of the moment is being real with yourself. You don't have to procrastinate. Procrastination is what is really hurting a lot of people right now. This is time to be realistic about this, your financial standing, all right? So you have to change things. You will make profit in your business after the pandemic is over. But see, right now, what you want to do is make money now. Just, you know, those little pennies that can keep you going. So, financial survivor. You have to learn new ways of surviving financially with what you already have. Now, on the local level, let me talk about the local level. Let me pick Nigeria, for instance, right now. Depending on your dream and what you want to achieve right now. This is not the time to go into selling secondhand clothes, which we call okrika. Because number one, you're going to have customs to deal with. You're not going to be able to bring it in. And you need to understand that at this point in time, people are not looking so much at clothes. They're looking at using the old clothes that they already have. Because two-thirds of the world, third world population people are living in poverty. Two-thirds of the third world country population is living in poverty. So now listen, what you're going to do is go into the kind of businesses that will make them interested, that would come to them to buy, make them come to you to buy. Why am I saying go into businesses that would make people want to buy services that people need every day? Food. Everybody must eat. In this pandemic era, and even after the pandemic era, post-pandemic, people must eat. Don't go into selling okrika because it's expensive at this time going to buy okrika bell. Why don't you go into selling foodstuff like crayfish, dry fish, fresh fish? This is the season for fresh fish right now in Nigeria, and people must eat. So I suggest, my advice is use the money that you have now invested in food business. Because people must eat. It's not going to give you the kind of profit that okrika business would give you selling secondhand clothes or, matter of fact, even selling a boutique would give to you. But guess what? Those little pennies, those little kobos and naira will count and it will keep you surviving. So really, the underlying factor here is actually staying afloat so you can keep pushing in order for you to have financial sustainability. Now, the word of God is very clear on this one. Yes, I had to go there. So give us this day our daily bread. Give us this day our daily bread. It didn't say give us tomorrow our daily bread. Matter of fact, what it says is worry not about tomorrow, for tomorrow will take care of itself. Sufficient for its own trouble is tomorrow. So whatever you are doing today, be contented with today. Think about today. You ever thought about having a little garden in your backyard where you cultivate something that you usually would buy from the grocery store or the open market, like pepper, onions?
Things are never what they seem to be. Changing minds, changing attitudes. Bring ourselves to live a busy world. Changing minds, changing attitudes. Bring ourselves to live a busy world. Show some love, hold each other's hands. In confidence we'll make the world a better place. We are changing minds and changing attitudes.
Watching the Princess Pat Akpabio Show.